When I was younger, I was really interested in getting into game development, but one thing that stopped me was my inability to draw or make arts from scratch. I knew there were websites where you could download assets made by other people, but I had a feeling that if I wanted to make something serious, I'd need to have some level of skill in art. Today, things are different. Thanks to the new advances in artificial intelligence, there are now a number of tools that can help you create 3D animation and gaming assets without any prior experience in art. One of the most popular tools is Stable Diffusion. Stable Diffusion is a text-to-image AI model that can generate high-quality images from text descriptions. There are already a number of custom plugins for Stable Diffusion, formerly they're called models. But don't let that confuse you with 3D models. In addition to Stable Diffusion, there are a number of AI-powered tools that can be used to create 3D assets for gaming. Midjourney was the first paid rival to DALL-E 2, and it runs primarily on Discord. Midjourney has a number of interesting features, and while none of them will directly convert your 2D images into 3D, they can be used in a number of ways to make that a reality. There is a free trial of sorts that you can use in one of the public channels, but once you've paid for however long you're interested, you can use it by direct message. I'd be here all day if I went into all the stuff you can do with Midjourney, but by using the image weights feature, you could get an image that would be perfect for the following websites. Common Sense Machines have an app called Cube that will create a 3D model out of an image. You can find a lot of great examples on the homepage, and you can even upload videos. It doesn't cost you anything to play around with the software, and the reason I've recommended the image weight feature is because it gives you the flexibility of controlling certain aspects of your image, such as giving it a white background or styling your character in a given pose so the 3D conversion knows what to look for. One drawback with Cube I found fairly quickly is that the textures it will use for your 3D models won't necessarily match the image you uploaded. I'm not sure why it happens, and I haven't found any reasoning about it online as of yet. Just adding this in from the editing phase, technology updates so fast these days, even more so when it's relating to AI. So basically, when I was writing this script, the model version number they were using was 1.0, which from my testing would generate 3D models with textures that weren't the same as the image you uploaded. So if you were to upload a photo of yourself and you happen to have a mustache, it would give you a 3D model of someone who looks like you with a mustache. In the original script, I theorized that it's because they would convert your photo into a very detailed description of your image, rather than the image itself. For example, I'd upload two photos of an American live streamer, who I won't name, only for one 3D model to be of someone of Arabic descent and the other Japanese. So this little portion of the video about Common Sense Machines has become a little bit outdated. I was going to try making the joke that the output was similar to something from GoldenEye on the Nintendo 64 or Perfect Dark, but look at these amazing results of Tom Cruise and Robert Downey Jr. You can see the version number at the top right there, but you can't access other models unless you pay for it. The colours are a bit of a trip, but they look quite good. Also, I'm not sure if Nintendo would come round and kick my ass if I tried using either of these soundtracks for like a second. Anyway, on with the show. But for someone who wants to tinker around and see what can be made with AI, it can be a fun experiment. If you did want to refine it even more, you can download it into a software like Blender and tinker around even more. I can imagine this is a benefit to animators and game developers alike who want to play into that for nostalgia. Plus, not all games require extremely detailed graphics. That's why the developers of Super Mario 64 made it so his model takes a downgrade when he's at a certain distance from the camera. And even though I said the textures may appear inaccurate, that doesn't stop someone putting the originals back in later. I joke about it looking like GoldenEye in the Nintendo 64, but its spiritual successor, Perfect Dark, was originally going to have a feature called Perfect Head, which would take any selfie and stick it onto the head of any random NPC in the game. It was eventually cut due to technical difficulties, but would have been interesting to see. Now technically speaking, this wasn't converting 2D to 3D, this was simply fitting a texture onto an existing model. But this feature reminds me of software developed by Reallusion. There's two I want to discuss here. Firstly, let's talk about Character Creator, which offers a plugin called Headshot. To install the Headshot plugin, you just need to download it from the website and follow the installation instructions. Once you've got that installed, you can just open it from the Character Creator software. To use the headshot plugin, simply drag and drop a photo of the person's face into the plugin window. The headshot plugin will then use AI to generate a 3D model of the person's face. You can then adjust the model's features to your liking. I do love how it just knows how to connect everything up. Reallusion Character Creator is expensive at $199, with another $199 on top of that for the headshot plugin. While it's an expensive kit, Reallusion Character Creator and Headshot can be used for more demanding projects, say PS4 or PS5 games, or even replace actors for specific scenes in movies. There's a film with Nicolas Cage in it called The Unbearable Weight of Massive Talent, where he stars as himself. If you enjoy Nicolas Cage movies, even as a guilty pleasure, you'll probably enjoy it. But anyway, there are certain scenes in the film where he imagines himself talking to a young doppelganger from his classic movies. You can tell it's CGI, it's super uncanny, but it's something you can imagine that software being used for. I'm not sure whether it's pronounced Reallusion or Reallusion, but anyway, the second piece of software I want to talk about by them is called iClone. When I first looked into this, I wasn't sure what sets it apart from the headshot plugin for Character Creator, but what I found is that iClone is a lot more focused on animation. The biggest difference being, because the headshot is more focused on creating 3D heads, it offers a level of realism that centers around heads and faces, whereas iClone is more general purpose. You can have props within a 3D scene with a timeline to beat. Neither of those things headshot has. The iClone software even offers the possibility of motion capture, which will never not remind me of this scene from The Simpsons. Let me discuss some other simple ways AI can interact with 3D. Did you know you can use ChatGPT to create 3D models? Well, you can. I've spoken about ChatGPT before in a previous video, but it's surprisingly competent at writing code and creating custom tutorials specifically catered to you. In this case, with a bit of trial and error, you can ask it to guide you through creating a three-dimensional masterpiece. Or you can even use it to instruct Blender through Python code. ChatGPT isn't the only player in town though, you've also got Google Bard and Bing Chat. We can go further than merely fetching ChatGPT code to feed into Blender, and use a relatively new software called Spline, which can be commanded through a text prompt from within the browser-based software itself. If you look at the live examples, you'll actually see many beautifully crafted pieces, such as this small bedroom. I can see this being used to influence full-blown architectural design that can be handed to engineers and the like. You can use it to create and enhance lighting systems, animations, and physics to a scene. You can also change the design of a scene you've already built. And that's another topic I wanted to touch upon. How can you use these systems to assist in the use of architecture in VR? And it's me again from the editing phase. Nothing has necessarily changed since the time I wrote this, but let's just say I didn't look into this as much as I should have done. I went into a bunch of technical waffle as to how expensive it would be if you were to try and create a VR app using DALL-E's credit system or monthly membership to Midjourney. As for Stable Diffusion, I didn't think it was viable due to how resource intensive it can be to even generate a single larger image. There are a bunch of tutorials you can find on YouTube covering the experiments people have done with a bunch of different plugins. For starters, we've got this tutorial which talks about how we can use Stable Diffusion coupled with some other extensions to create a panoramic image with the required depth to look great with any VR headsets. You can actually upscale your images too separately, which is how you can get these images up to 4K and beyond. And then there's this project, which aims to use Stable Diffusion to change a scene in real time in a virtual space. From the looks of it, it happens through a stream of different images being fed through rented hardware. I know that was a bit of a ramble, but it's just to emphasise that I think a more natural approach would be what's similar to what's known as procedural generation. Everything in a scene is randomised around a bunch of rules you've created yourself. An example would be a maze. You can have as many branching pathways as you want, but there'll always need to be a way out. Now think back to that example scene on the Spline website. Imagine if you could go back and forth through the voice-activated AI that could reconstruct any environment on your command. You would be the one in charge of when you changed the design of your kitchen. Now if you're wondering how you can make money with all this technology, I always recommend getting yourself a website up and running no matter what you do. I know you'll see that advice everywhere you go, but like all things IT related, you'll probably want to use a tutorial or something rather than use a service that can do it for you. As for starters, you'll have more flexibility, but it further shows that you're serious. With the exposure, you can also use LinkedIn for the networking vibes. Employees headhunt on there all the time, so it'll give you a chance to get mingling with all your work on display. Yes, LinkedIn is more for employment, but it is still work. When I was in university, I remember our tutor telling us that before you search for employment, you'll probably be working for yourself for a while. For a lot of people, that's generally their main goal for various reasons. The average 9-to-5 cannot fit their schedule. Websites such as Fiverr, PeoplePower, Upwork and Freelancer can all be used to create gigs and temporary work. There is competition, and that's never been out of the question, but these platforms do have the facilities to interact with clients and make offers. You don't have to advertise that you use AI. In fact, if you type in 2D to 3D into the search bar on Fiverr, you'll find a lot of pages that don't include AI in the main description. Now don't get me wrong, I'm not saying you shouldn't disclose it, especially if people ask, but I would get used to only using it to assist in your business venture. You'll be able to design logos for clients, add an extra dimension to landscapes and architecture, and even bring people's characters to life. You don't strictly need to use 3D modeling software either, as clients will be happy with that their 2D image looks like their drawing. Midjourney and Stable Diffusion can easily be used for those endeavours. So can you make money using AI to turn 2D to 3D? Well, a simple answer is yes you can, but let me elaborate on that a little bit more. Reallusion Character Creator coupled with Headshot is probably the highest quality software I've seen whilst researching for this video, but even then you need to know what project you're working on before you rake in any cash. As for now though, I think I'm going to end it there as I feel like I've given you enough food for thought. It's hard, and I know people are concerned that the better AI gets, the less money you will be able to make. But that's why I wanted to start this little series of upgrading your life with AI. But right now though, I think we're still at a stage where we can still provide enough value to make a living. But if you did appreciate what I have to say, I'd appreciate a like and subscribe, and thanks for watching. Bye.